Hello viewers, welcome to Home Cooking. Today's recipe is a very interesting and special iftar recipe for this Ramadan festival. So let's check out the ingredients and see how this recipe is made. Soak 1 cup of pitted dates in 1 cup of hot water. Soak the dates for about 15 minutes till they become nice and soft. So I'm just going to dissolve some sugar. For half cup of water, I'm using half cup of sugar. Once the sugar is dissolved, turn off the stove and keep this sugar syrup aside. We're going to roast some nuts. Take a little ghee, starting with almonds, 1/4 cup, walnuts, 1/4 cup, cashew nuts, 1/4 cup, pistachios, 1/4 cup. Once the nuts are roasted, keep it aside. Take a little ghee, raisins, 1 teaspoon of chiroli seeds, 2 teaspoons melon seeds. Turn off the stove and keep this aside. Grind this to a nice fine puree. Now I'm going to grind the nuts to a nice coarse powder. To the same pan, add 1 tablespoon of ghee. Pour the date puree into the pan. After 5 minutes, add the sugar syrup. Continue to cook on medium flame till the mixture thickens. Keep stirring at intervals. You can see this mixture has become very thick and nice. Now would be a good time to add the powdered nuts. Mix it. Now add the powdered cardamom. Mix everything together. The halwa is coming along beautifully. You can see it's thickened. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of ghee. Continue to stir it till it forms a nice thick mass and all this excess moisture is evaporated. So the halwa is done. You can see it's come together beautifully. Turn off the stove. Now I'm going to set the halwa in a nice dish. You can use either a plate or a nice dish of your choice. So here I'm taking a small dish. I'm just going to grease it with a little ghee on all sides. Once I set this, I'm going to leave it out to cool. You can refrigerate this or you can leave it out to cool completely. And the halwa will thicken and it will become hard. And if you'd like to cut it into small pieces, you can cut them and eat them, or you can even serve it in a cup. Now I'm going to sprinkle the roasted raisins, chironji seeds and the melon seeds. Gently press it in. So you can either set this halwa like this in a small dish, or you can serve it as is. You can serve it hot in a cup. So whichever way you prefer, you can eat it like that. As you can see, the halwa is very simple to prepare. It's a great recipe to try for this festive season. You can get a copy of our first edition of the Home Cooking book on Amazon and 21 Prints.